then you will be taken. No question of formalities. All these great people who are called the masters of wisdom, they exist as intelligence of nature everywhere on this earth. They are always ready to take notice of anyone who is sincere. There is no question of being overlooked. They begin to stimulate your evolution. And when such a thing is possible, when you are made a creator of your own destiny, the scriptures promise you that what is prophesied in the Black Age is only a probability which can be made a dream, a falsehood. The possibility can be neutralized because there are two probabilities in the form of future. If you take one path, you will reach destruction. If you take another path, you will take what is called the future of humanity. So the same scriptures promises that there is nothing like destiny. There is only a plan. If you obey and give your cooperation to the plan, everything is changed from darkness to light. If you disobey and want to live as an individual away from the future of the rest of the humanity, you will create your own miserable future. And whenever individuals create such future, then they will have a global war. It has happened many thousands of times in the history of this earth. And once again, we are heading towards that probability. But even in the past, there were periods when humanity averted the dangers and entered into periods of safety and security. Whenever they averted a global war, there was no record in any scripture, because only if a war is fought, there will be a record. For a war which is not fought, there will not be any record. So only whenever humanity failed, there was a destruction, and the destructions are recorded in the scriptures. And the probability is periodical, and the destruction is not inevitable. So understand nature's workings, understand what is inevitable, and understand what can be changed. There is certain amount of future which can be changed, the key of which is placed in your hand. That which cannot be changed, the keys are in the hands of nature. With your good behavior to yourselves, to yourself, and good behavior towards others, good behavior with other kingdoms, you can always avert your own danger. Just as you can live a healthy life by a good behavior, you can make the society healthy by your presence and create a better society which easily overcomes the danger of war. This is the solution, and always it is the only solution. Let us not confuse ourselves by believing that everything is predestined, or by believing that everything can be changed. So we are living in change on the platform of something which cannot be changed. So we are having a life of eternal values, and we are living a life of changed values. On the platform of eternal values, let us live a life of change, a change from worse to better, because every one of us is created as a creator. Unlike the animals or the plants, we are given the power of discrimination, which is not given to the animals or the plants or minerals. We are expected to use discrimination by nature. Nature always has great hopes about the human kingdom, because it has given the power of discrimination to the human kingdom. It expects us to use discrimination and change that can be changed, and create that can be created. Let us not create our own destruction, our own disease, our own misery, our own enmity. So let us create our own future, and let every one of us contribute to that end without thinking what others are doing. Don't expect others to understand what you do, and don't wait till others do good things. let it be started with you. Let others take their own time to understand you. That is the solution. And beyond this, no solution has been given by any modern thinker till today. And this solution is age old. It has been given by all the scriptures. And the authors of the scriptures have given the same solution through thousands of years. And if any one of you have a better solution, or if any modern thinker has given a better practical solution, let us follow it. But until then, let us not be carried away by the glamour of intellectualism. Let us remember only practicality and the workability of a theory, but not the rare features of a theory. Let us not care what is valuable. Let us care what is useful. Let us not care for what is great. Let us care for what is good. Let us be free from glamour. And if there is a real practical solution for the better, let us include ourselves with that and make a contribution of our life to it. Except this, till now there is no solution. And think of the issue with a calm mind. And don't forget that you are inseparable from the total humanity of this earth. Don't forget that you too are a creator. And don't forget that you can either produce a perfume or a stinking smell in this society. Then remember what you have to contribute to this society. There ends our duty. Thank you all. Since about 5000 and odd BC, Aquarian Age. Aquarian Age is a smaller cycle. It is called a sub-cycle.
Il est appelé un sous-cycle.
Or a zodiacal cycle. Whereas the Iron Age belongs to bigger cycles. According to the astronomers, the present Aquarian Age started exactly on the date when Queen Victoria came to the throne in England. And in many respects, it is true and verified, because one of the features of the Aquarian Age is that women gain prominence in social and political and international affairs. And since then, the age of personal importance has gone. No politician or no scientist in the world can have a total control of affairs of anything. That is what is called the Verso or the Aquarian Age. Whereas the Iron Age is a bigger age. The Aquarian Age is a sub-age or a local age. If you take the 12 signs of the zodiac, there are 360 degrees. Each sign has 30 degrees. And for the equinox to make a precession, it takes 72 years for a degree. 72 into 30 is the period of each age. There was the Aryan period, and then there was the Piscean period, and then now it is, and it travels in the anti-clockwise direction. The next age will be the age of Capricorn. Yes, these are called sub-cycles. Whereas the bigger cycles are yugas, they are very big in number. They are called yugas, which can be understood by studying the secret doctrine of Blavatsky or the treatise on the cosmic fire by Alice A. Bailey. In its true sense, there is only one yoga, though many people use it in many senses. And the one which you are questioning about is exactly the same that is given by the masters of wisdom. And in the modern age, it is given through the works of Alice Bailey, and many thousands of groups are at work in many countries. And gradually, the groups are forming into a network. I too believe, that we can help the situation only by increasing the numbers of people who take part in it. And that is possible only by offering ourselves as an individual into it. And there our duty ends. And continuously we are expected to work for the planet. That is the total behavior of the humanity of the planet. And there is a system of yoga which includes not 1 or 2 or 3 hours of our meditation, but includes the whole life activity of individuals and such individuals forming into groups. One whole group living as one person with the so many bodies. It is quite possible and it is taking gaining momentum in the modern age. But since it is an age of a critical situation in human evolution, there is also the evil aspect that is magnified and appearing to our mind. That is the political and the religious situations of the world. But at the same time, the group work of the new yoga appears sufficient to make everything clear. It only takes some time because it is a matter that concerns with our evolution. This is where we stand tomorrow.